Working with the module database is fairly easy. There's really three sort of different ways that you can manipulate the module database. You can either use the PI module database editor within the PI System Manager Tools application. You can use the PI module database builder. That's an add-in to Excel that's very similar to our tag configurator. And you can programmatically build and edit modules as well, and that's a little bit more difficult, but the module database is open to full programmatic access, so you can use any of those methodologies to build and maintain your module database. We're going to take a look at the first two, the module database editor in the SMT tool and the module database builder, the add-in to Excel. The module database editor in the PI SMT, or System Manager Tools version 3, is a very easy way to build modules, aliases, and properties one at a time. And that's an interesting caveat, important caveat to remember, because if you have to do hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of these, it's probably not the tool that you're going to use to do the bulk creation. However, even if you had thousands of module database entries to build, you probably will start with the module database editor. Now I've got my PI System Management Tools open, and the module database editor is under the Operation tab. And when you select the module database editor, you're going to be presented with your server and then the modules. You don't want to be changing things in the %OSI module. That is where we use as a sort of pseudo registry for our applications, and in fact you would even find ACE entries in there. You would want to create your own modules at the basic module level and build upon that. And if you remember earlier, we had the reactor section with our aliases and properties. And I'll show you how easy it is to build a module. You simply right click where it says modules and select new, and you would simply give your module name, give your module a new name here, replacing the new module entry, and we're going to call this, let's call this Site 1, and we want to click OK. And under Site 1, I'm going to say I have a number of different units that I want to create. So I'll right-click on that and select New Module. And the new module I want to create is simply Unit 1. And you'll notice that it does have all of the standard owner, group, and world security rights that any of our other objects in PI do. And I'll click OK at that point. And you'll notice that under Site 1, I now have Unit 1. And if I wanted to add aliases and properties to that, I could very easily do that by right-clicking and say New Alias. I could add the alias here. Let's add an alias called temperature, and we'll click on the magnifying glass to bring up our tag search, and I'm going to select a tag sort of at random here, and then you'll see that I now have an alias there. I can also add properties to that as well. For example, I select new and property. The property name I want is manufacturer, and the data type is going to be string, and the value is going to be GE. We'll say GE made this particular unit, and there we have our property. We could add more aliases like this, or we could add more properties like this. When we get our unit complete the way we like it, we can simply right-click and say copy, and then right-click on our site level and say paste. Now you want to be careful when you're copying and pasting modules to paste value and hierarchy. There should be a little and symbol there. And what that's going to do is it's going to paste all the values and all the hierarchy from your original module. If you would have just selected paste, it would have given you a new empty module. So at this point, I can rename my module. I can call this Unit 2, and I can then go in and edit any of the aliases and properties at that point to make them unique. Let's take a look at the PI module database builder. And it works almost exactly like our PI tag configurator. In fact, I'm going to open up Excel. And if you notice under the PI SMT menu, there is module database builder. Now there's two things you're going to want to check before you actually start using this. First, you're going to want to make sure your connections are set. You want to make sure you have a connection to the PI server that you're using. And it's very often helpful to come into settings and to select shade cells that do not apply and to apply a color to different modules. This is simply so you can see the line items a little bit easier. By default, these both come unchecked. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my module database builder and I'm going to import certain items from my PI server. And you want to make sure here you don't import the entire module database. You want to pick the level that you really want to work with. And you want to pick that and so you don't get thousands and thousands or hundreds of rows that you're not going to use. In my case, I want to select my site number one and I want to see that hierarchy come into my spreadsheet. So I'll select site one and click OK. And what you'll see is that all of my site comes in with my module names shown in column B and all of the module database components or attributes are listed here across in row number one as headings. And what we want to do at this point is clone one of the units and create more units on my site based on one of these in a much faster methodology than pointing and clicking. And all we're really interested in here is the last fields here, alias, data source, property type, and property value. Everything else we're going to let default. We're going to let the system default those values. So I'm going to delete all of the cells between type and alias data source. And the next step I'm going to do is I'm going to tell the module database builder to deselect all the fields. And then I'm going to go in and manually select all the fields next to unit 1. I'm then going to copy those rows and paste them. So essentially I have two complete unit 1s here. I'm going to take my first unit 1 and replace unit 1 with unit 3. I am going to take my second unit 1 and I'm going to replace my unit 1 with unit 4. I'll replace all. And essentially what I've done is I have created a new unit 3 with one alias and one property, and a unit 4 with one alias and one property. Now I could change the tag names here and the property values, but I'll save that for a little later time when we've got some time to go and tweak things. I want to show you the whole point of this tool though, is that I can take these new units that don't exist in my module database and I can export them to my PI server under the correct mode. I usually just select create or edit because it covers both. And then click OK. And what you should find when you go either do another import to import all your units, or if you were to go into your module database tool, I'll reset my view. I should see all of my new units here, and I do, units 3 and units 4. And those units have the appropriate aliases and properties. I could either tweak the aliases and properties in the Excel spreadsheet and re-export them, or I could go into here and tweak the tag names at this point. Either way you do it, you're going to end up with the same result. So you can see how using the module database builder in Excel is much faster to create many, many units than it would be to point and click through the module database builder.